All right. If we can get our seats, we're going to go ahead and get going here with our concert for our opening night of Sharon Camp Meeting. I think 2021, does that sound right? I've lost a year and a half somewhere along the line and still trying to figure out when it is and what it is. But 2021, and we're ready to begin another camp meeting, and we've had to make some adjustments and changes along the way, but we are ready to go, and we're expecting God to meet with us in a great way during these next 9 days after tonight. And we're just praying that we will hear that people have been obedient to what God wants for their lives. And that's what camp meetings are all about, is hearing the voice of God afresh and anew in a different way. And we're going to start doing that tonight when we introduce our concert soloist. But let's have a stand and have a word of prayer together. Heavenly Father, we do thank you and praise you for the opportunity again to be in your presence. We thank you for sharing camp meeting and for what it's meant for so many down through the years. And this is another year that we want to give to you and pray that you will bless our time together, and everyone that enters these campgrounds will feel the presence of the Holy Spirit in a very special and unique way. We pray that you'll be with Brother Ken Osborne tonight as he sings for us. May the words touch our hearts and our minds. May we walk in obedience to what you have for us. For all it's accomplished, we give you praise in the precious name of Jesus, and we do thank you. Amen. 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 You may be seated. And at this time, we're going to turn it over for the first, about two-thirds to Ken, and allow him to sing for us, and then we'll have a little break and give him the rest of the evening.
Thank you, Brother David. Solomon, in the prayer that he gave at the dedication of the temple that he built, said, "There is no God that's going to sleep on it." Click on it somewhere. There you go. A little hop on the program. Anyway, back to what I was saying. He prayed, "There is no God like our God in heaven above or earth beneath, who keeps covenant and shows mercy to those who follow, who walk before him in love." There is a thing like no other. Oh, all right. My wife starts over. I'm not going to give the opening marks again, because I lost my place. Aren't you thankful you know him tonight? Amen. We have a call like no other, reigning high upon his throne. He is the Lord. He's our Father and sovereign power. He rules alone, yet he came and dwelt among us. Open wide his loving hands. He took the nail to be our Savior, a greater one there's never been. Oh, there's never been a more precious sense ever pierced our struggling cross. Oh, there's never been a more blessed plan, salvation for the lost. Oh, there's never been another perfect man who would die for one and all. Never one crucified to live again. Hallelujah. He's a God who's gone where others have never been. Well, praise the Lord. Amen. Listen to this. He changes lives like no other. Gives a peace forevermore. Forgives the sin of the sinner through his blood. What a story, a blessed and never pierced on a rugged cross. Oh, there's never been a more blessed plan, salvation for the lost. Oh, there's never been another perfect man who would die for one and all. Never one crucified to live again. Hallelujah, he's the God who's gone where others have never been. Never one crucified to live again. Hallelujah, he's the God who's gone where others have never been. Never been. Well, it's certainly a pleasure to be here and be with you this few days. And I'm thankful for a God who intervenes in our life, does many wonderful things for us. Every morning when I wake, see the sun, I can't help but think about the Lord and all the things he's done. He meets my every need, you see, he's been so good to me, and I can't help but praise the Lord for all he's done. For all he's done, gonna lift my hands and praise him for all he's done. Gonna live my life to please him, even though I don't deserve. Praise the Lord for all he's done. There are many things that I could praise God for. If I started now until I die, there'd still be many more. If I could mention only one, I'd have to thank him for his son. That's enough. Praise the Lord for all he's done. For all he's done, gonna lift my hands and praise him for all he's done. Gonna live my life to please him, even though I don't deserve to live. My life has just begun and I can't help. Praise the Lord for all he's done. For all he's done, gonna lift my hands and praise him for all he's done. Gonna live my life to please him, even though I don't deserve to live. My life is just even though I don't deserve to live, my life is just begun, and I can't help but praise the Lord for all he's done, for all he's done. someone with you. How about that? Everyone bring somebody along with you for camp meeting the days ahead. But it is a time of refreshing, reinvigorating, or really seeing what God would have us to do, to come together with folks of like precious faith, to worship the Lord who gave himself, as we've just been singing about, and gave himself for our redemption, the plan of salvation. And I'm so glad to be able to sing about that and to share it with you tonight. I don't know, I look around, like I said, it's been quite a while. In fact, it's been 10 years. Last time we were here is in 2011. And I do see some familiar faces and some that not so familiar. How many have never heard me sing and be with Ann? How many have, this is brand, I'm a brand new face to you. Well, there are some names, some hands, and my wife, I'd like to introduce my wife to you. I'm sure you figured out who she is. She's up here by herself, but you know, I have people say to me afterwards, they'll say to me, I enjoyed watching your wife smile. And I've tried to figure it out, because she always sits up front and most everybody is behind her. Does she have a smile in the back of her head too? Anyway, I'd like you to see her smile from the front side. This is my wife, Ann. Would you make it? Brings to mind a story. You know, Ann and I have been here in other years, and we brought some of our grandchildren with us. We bring them one. Well, one time we had two of them here at the same time. Decided we'd never do that again. But we usually brought one at a time. And Tia was here. I don't know what year it was. I've forgotten. But Tia was ever since she was a little girl was Miss Pris.
She was born a penis. Does that tell you?
Anyway, Tia just loved to be over. We lived next door to them, or they lived next door to us, I guess. And Tia, all the grandkids would come over. There was four of them down there, and would come over and spend time with us. And we were living in a fifth wheel at the time. But Tia was down visiting Grandma one day. And Ann was up in the bedroom, and she's, I don't know what she was doing, putting on makeup. She didn't wear much makeup, but she was doing her thing, whatever you ladies do in the bedroom with a mirror. And Tia says, Grandma, can I see your eyes? And Ann looked at her. I guess she was putting an eyebrow pencil on or something. Looked at her, and Tia says, no, the ones in the back of your head. Evidently, our son had told them that Grandma had eyes in the back of her head. And you ladies, I don't know how you do that, but you do. Sometimes we wonder about what we do. How many here have been Sunday school teachers? How many? A number of you. How many of our pastors? Okay, there's several that are pastoring and have pastored at the time, and maybe you're pastoring now. How many have just been a janitor in the church? Yes. All the pastors raised their hand. Anyway, I remember I've taught Sunday school class, and I taught junior boys. I call them the terrorists of the church. You know, they just couldn't, you know, what one didn't think of, the other one did. And I remember one Sunday going home very discouraged about teaching that junior class of boys. There was, I don't know, eight or nine of them. But it didn't seem like I was getting anywhere with them. I don't know if the moon was right or what it was, but they just didn't seem to be paying any attention to what I was doing or saying. The next Sunday, as we got together, and one of the things I always did for the Sunday school class is just kind of review what we had talked about, what our lesson was about the Sunday before. And so I asked them, not expecting an answer, but the boy that seemed to be the instigator of getting things started raised his hand, and he could have taught the lesson. And it was then that I realized that, you know, we do our part and leave the rest to God, to do what needs to be done. So this song was written a few years ago, and I trust to be an encouragement to you to recognize that one day God will show us the faces of Sunday school class members or parishioners, those that have been in our church, and they have come to the Lord. I dream my life was done. I stood before God's Son. It was time to see what my reward would be. ordained at 31, so we're actually in 32 years of full-time ministry with music ministry. The Lord has blessed us way beyond measure. When we started, we just thought we'd be doing a few concerts in Michigan, but God has opened the door. We've traveled over pretty much mostly east of the Mississippi, along the East Coast, and we've met a lot of folks along the way, folks just like you, that just desire to serve the Lord and to be what He'd have us to be, to reach out and help a friend or a neighbor or a loved one, family member, to come to know Jesus. And we've just thrilled at the opportunities we've had. One of the songs that we sang early on became a favorite of just about everywhere we went, and for a number of years it was our most requested song. And so I thought I would throw that one in here tonight. My mother is just turned 99 this year, and one of my favorite memories of growing up in a Christian home was many times at the end of the day, Mom would call my two sisters and I from a day of play outside and get us cleaned up. We lived on a farm, so we did all the things that farm kids do. You know, we rode the calves, played in the haymow, and just, I see some of you nodding. You had the privilege to do that too. But she'd get us cleaned up. It's something about keeping the sheets clean, I think it was. But she would line my two sisters and I up on the edge of the bed and read us a story. More often than not, it was a Bible story. And I can still see my most favorite story in that little golden book, I believe they called it, of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Three young men, probably 15, 16 years of age, who said, King Nebuchadnezzar, we will not bow to your golden image, no matter how hot you heat your furnace, because our God is able to deliver us from that fiery furnace. But if not, He is still God. Amen. And so this song, let it be an encouragement to you. He's still in the fire. He's still with us today. My mother read a story from the Bible long ago, about Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, how the wicked king commanded they be thrown into the flame, because they would not bow and deny their father's name. Mama said the king stood high upon a balcony so tall, when he looked in he was shocked by all the things he saw, 'cause church sometimes has, maybe for whatever reason, I can't say that it's necessarily sleek, but we kind of back off for fear that we be accused of ramming something down somebody's throat. Or maybe we just want to be kind and gentle and sweet to everyone around us. And certainly, Jesus exemplified that, but Jesus stood and did not let them defeat him. He stood for what was right, and he spoke out against what was wrong. You read the word, just read the word. And Jesus was not quiet. And so, but I think today, well, this song was written back in the early 90s by a friend of ours. Some of you would know him. He played piano for the Cathedral Quartet, Roger Bennett. And he wrote this song, and I've wondered if he were to write this song today, just how he would write it, maybe a little different. But we have a marvelous message to carry to a world around us, a message of hope and freedom, freedom from the things that bind us. And, well, the simple message, Jesus saves. The church has been silent while the world raised its voice. Loud and angry tones they took the lead. All across creation there's
Hey, how about that? Amen. Are you enjoying it tonight? Thanks for being here. Steve, could you grab the offering buckets back there and maybe Grady lend him a hand on this side? And we'll take up our offering, and I'm going to hum or sing for the offering. Just, you can play something. Yeah, if you have something, that'll be a lot better. But we will beginning tomorrow, have our Bible study at 2 o'clock, and it's great to have retired or semi-retired majors, Michaels, with us. Connie will be doing our Bible study. Stand and let him see you there, Connie. And we'll be doing that over in the cow because it's air-conditioned for afternoons. Keep you awake. And there's coffee over there, so hopefully that'll help too. And then, oh, the cow, the center of worship for youth. Sorry about that. New camper. The youth fondly call it the cow. then it's at 7 o'clock, our regular scheduled evening service, and retired Major Rick Michaels will be giving our sermons. And, of course, you've already heard Ken, and he's going to be leading our music. And I know Kelly at least is going to be trying to do most of the piano playing. You can't replace Grace, but we're going to keep going on anyway, all right? And so we may have some others that have to help and stand in now and then, but Kelly's going to help us out there. So we're just looking forward to some great times here during the camp meeting. And I know that we had to make, again, some adjustments, but God has helped us to make those adjustments. As Ken said, we didn't get to call him till January when I got an email from Brian canceling because he had to take a job. And I know he's gone back on the road some. But we had to make sure we filled the spot. And so Ken came, and we're so glad he's been able to be here and start out our camp meeting with this concert and some of these great songs. He hasn't sung my favorite yet, Deep in the Sea. But I know sooner or later it's going to happen, right? Okay. Down Deep in the Sea. That's my favorite. But I enjoy the Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego, and all the rest. He's doing a great job. All right, let's pray for the offering. Heavenly Father, as we come to you this evening, we again thank you for what you've done. You have helped us through some great obstacles over the last couple of years with this project that we had, over $120,000 to pay for, in addition to the regular finances of the camp, and our loan is down to $12,000 after just raising money for a little over a year. And so God's people have been good, God is blessed, and we're continuing to have camp meeting because we believe there is a place in people's heart and people's lives and in the life of the church for camp meeting. And so we pray that you'll bless this offering and use it to its intended use wherever you might see fit. We ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
surgeries, had 7 more surgeries because of infection. So I've had 11 surgeries. My doctor, my orthopedic doctor, when I was in to see him about 3 years ago on a follow-up thing, he had me walk across the room and back again without my cane. And he said, "I'm surprised you're still walking."
But he is.
But I'm walking. And so sometimes I complain about gimping around and not getting around as good, but I recognize I'm still walking. And I thank the Lord for the privilege. Well, just to share a little bit of the testimony, I could take hours to do it, and I'm not going to do that tonight because that's not why we're here. We just thank the Lord to be able to serve Him, to be with you this year. In our traveling, we, as I said a little while ago, we traveled mostly east of the Mississippi. We did make one trip, a couple of trips out west with our ministry, but we found enough places to sing here and didn't have to deal with the mountains, except the Appalachians. But anyway, we were singing in Hendersonville, North Carolina here a few years ago, and for our camp meeting. And our motorhome was parked about a block, maybe 2 blocks from the tabernacle. And the first night of the camp meeting, after the services, I and I were leaving, we were one of the last ones out. There was a lady sitting there with a golf cart, and she said, "Would you like a ride back to your motorhome?" That time, I was walking on a cane, and I don't think Ann was yet, but anyway, we gladly accepted the ride back to the motorhome. The next morning, and forever morning after that camp, she lived in a cottage or a house across the drive from where our motorhome was parked. And in the mornings when I'd come out, she'd be sitting on the porch, and when she'd see me come out, she quickly got in her golf cart, came over, and gave me a ride down to the tabernacle so I'd get music and things ready for the day. One morning, about the third morning, as I was getting in the golf cart, she said to me, "You sang a song yesterday morning in the service that the kitchen crew was not able to hear the words very well and didn't hear all the song and wondered if you would sing it again." I said, "Well, I don't normally repeat songs. I've got so many that I'd like to sing." She said, "Do you want to ride down there or do you want to walk?" It's amazing how quickly a song evangelist can change his mind. And so I did, and this is that song. It's a song a lot of songwriters, painters of pictures, try to envision through their words or picture what heaven is going to be like. And this is what one songwriter wrote down of what he felt heaven is going to be like. End of the day, I laid down my head. I slept real good, then I rose from my bed. Good morning. Good morning. Oh, but things were changed. Was I in a dream? The walls all around me had a jasper gleam. The door was pearl and the floor was gold. I looked at myself and I wasn't old. Stepped outside to see what I could see. There was Paul and Silas waving at me. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning to the place called eternity. Good morning to the place made for you and me. Good morning to the day where there is no night. Good morning where the Son of God is our light. Good morning, let's go down where the children meet, and we'll worship God at Jesus' feet. Good morning. Good morning. So I went along, the feeling was grand. The people there were shaking my hand. Good morning. Good morning. peers could I find. All sorrow had ceased. Then Mom and Dad came around the bend. Hello, my son, it's good to see you again. Good morning. Good morning to the place called eternity. Good morning to the place made for you and me. Good morning to the day where there is no night. Good morning where the Son of God is our light. Good morning, let's go down where the children meet. And we'll worship God at Jesus' feet. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Then I heard a voice that I longed to hear. I came and I bowed with love and with fear. Then Jesus spoke from his mighty throne. He said, good morning, child. Welcome home. Good morning to the place called eternity. Good morning to the place made for you and me. Good morning to the day where there is no night. Good morning where the Son of God is our light. Good morning, let's go down where the children meet. Then we'll worship God at Jesus' feet. Good short and was called Beloved Enemy. It was a true story that told about this young lady, a beautiful young woman, that was at college, and there was a young man that became interested in her, and so he invited her out on a date. She asked him, "Are you a Christian?" And he said, "No. In fact, I'm an agnostic." And she said, no, she wouldn't go out with him. A few days later, he asked the same question. He was very persistent, and again, her reply was no. Finally, one time, he asked her again a few days later, and he said, "If I can prove to you that what you believe is just fantasy, and that these miracles that are written in an ancient book called the Bible, if I can prove to you that that's all it is, just fantasy and somebody's figment of their imagination, would you go out with me?" And she said, yes. So he set out to prove his point. And after studying and research for some time, realized that he was wrong. That Jesus, in fact, was the Son of God. That it was all true what the Bible said. And he gave his heart and life to the Lord. So this song fits that story so very well. Listen to it as we share it.
Typical day on Golgotha, where men struck me what this song is all about. You know, sometimes we can say, you may be tempted, or maybe before you became a Christian, you say, when you're going through a tough time or a sense of rejection, you can say, God, you don't understand. But he does. Listen carefully to these words as we close with this song. Just suppose the world turned against you and nobody ever spoke a kind word. And suppose all your loved ones forsake you, you can still find refreshing. You know, as a Christian, sometimes we get downhearted, don't we? I do. Maybe I'm just speaking. Maybe I'm the only one. I feel like I'm the only one. Then I'm reminded, Jesus walked this path alone for you and me. Let's find what he has for us.
We will be moving up onto the platform beginning tomorrow night, so you might want to come down a little bit farther. We left this space right here because remember the last few years we've had some leak, but that was patched this morning and we're hoping it holds for camp meeting. So you might want to bring your lawn chairs down a little closer so you can be closer to the singing and the preaching and get more involved in the service. But we'd like for you to, you know, to make your way down, and as Ken said, invite others to come along and make sure they know about the camp meeting and that God is here in a real way. And again, we're thankful for each one that's here tonight, and may God continue to bless you. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your presence and for what you have spoken to us through the words of these great songs, and we pray, oh God, that you'll continue to bless as we do the Bible studies and the evening services. and the singing and the praying and the giving, all of it may it be giving honor and glory to your name as we continue to serve you and do your will. Be with us in a special way. Watch over and protect us on the way home and bring us back to be a part of the camp meeting as often as possible. We ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen.